Hello and welcome to our lecture on functions and modularity. So why do we use functions? Well, certainly we accomplish so many things in PHP using functions because it's not strings, for example, are not objects, and so we pass strings into functions all the time to do basic string manipulation. And of course, as our application gets more complex, we're going to write a lot of functions ourselves to reuse perhaps for ourselves and perhaps for other folks. I think it's a mistake in computer science to basically say that writing functions is important. I mean, it's an important skill, but it's not like you have to write them if you don't feel like it. Straight line code is fine. The key is there will come a time when you'll want to write functions. You'll just want to not repeat yourself and be like, you know, I'm doing this similar thing over and over again. I'll turn a parameter in. I'll pull this stuff out because I got to use it here and in this other file, etc. And so it's just the goal of not repeating yourself, and it greatly increases the reliability of your programs when you use it. PHP has a language. The function calls are a little harder to remember, and so I really kind of need Google all the time when I'm programming. And so, you know, I'll say, hey, what's the string replace function? I know right now that it's str underscore replace, but I don't always know the order of the parameters. So Google is very good at finding you on the first click right to the kind of documentation that you need. You know, and so you're hitting the str replace, and there you go, and it's like, oh yeah, the search replace, and then the subject. And so if you look at this particular call, this is a non-object-oriented style of a call. In an object-oriented language like with strings as objects, in a language like Python, you'd say string.replace, old, new. Here, you have to pass the string in as one of the parameters. I would hope that someday in a future version of PHP, they would give us the alternative of a string being an object, but who knows if that's going to happen. But there's tons of string manipulation functions. Here's just a couple. You know, reversing a string, repeating it and concatenating it to itself twice, sending it to uppercase, and asking how long it is. Okay, so str len. You'll notice they often start with str, and that is the pattern of how you have global functions that really would make more sense as part of an object, but they're not. So there you go. To define your own functions, there's a keyword called function, and you give the function name, an optional list of parameters, and then a starting curly brace and an ending curly brace, and then the function is the body. And of course, it's the store and repeat pattern where as PHP runs this code, it is simply remembering this new greet thing. It's like, okay, that's what you want me to do later whenever you say greet, and then you invoke it. So it runs and runs the code, comes back, runs it again, comes back. And so this is the invoking of a function or calling of the function, and this is the defining. The top part is the defining of the function. And so that's the syntax. It's the word function followed by the name of the function, optional parameters, and then a curly brace block that is the body of the function. Function names are very similar to variable names. You can't start them with a dollar sign, so that means letters or underscores, and then the rest of it can be letters, numbers, or underscores. You don't want to define your own function that overlaps an existing function, so be careful about that. Case does not matter, but please don't count on that. Always write your code in a way that case matches, because who knows, in some future version, things may be different. Return values, like most C-based languages, the return statement takes a value and it replaces in the expression. And so here we have this expression that's being evaluated, greeting concatenated, function greeting concatenated with this string space Glenn. And so as PHP is evaluating this, it's like, oh, I got to go call this code. So it calls the code. And this happens just return hello. And the return bit sort of replaces the function in the expression that's halfway through being evaluated. So hello gets concatenated to Glenn, and then out comes hello Glenn. We do the same thing. The hello replaces the greeting, and then it becomes hello Sally. And so the return basically within an expression replaces the function call value with the return value. And you can, you know, this is just one line, keep it small on a slide. The return statement is an executable statement. It doesn't have to be the last line. It can be anywhere within. And when it executes inside of a function, it both stops function execution and determines what the residual value in the original calling expression is going to be. Arguments are simply variables that are, they're sort of not really real variables. They're placeholders that are aliases in a sense. So in this particular bit of code, if we're going to, we're going to take the language in as a parameter. Now, $lang sorted doesn't exist as a variable. It is an alias in the first call to the string quote es quote. And then it runs and does the thing and it returns, in this case, hola, Glenn. And then the second time, it is an alias to quote fr quote. So it's not a real variable. It is an alias to that which is the first parameter in the call. And away we go. I like how PHP does optional arguments. You simply say, if this argument doesn't exist, in this case, if lang is not presented as a, if it's missing from the arguments, set it to ES. So that's the default. The ES is the default in this particular thing. And sometimes we actually have a default value. In this case, we'll just assume Spanish is our default language. Or you can say false, and then you can check to see if it's false. And so sometimes we set the default in a way to know if it's submitted in your code, and then you have an if statement to say if it's false, da-da-da, and then you can know what you want to do if it's if the statement wasn't parameter wasn't present. And if you put the parameter in, then this part here is ignored, and it just is the alias for the first parameter to the function call. Normally, in most languages, we do what's called call by value, and that is that because this variable is an alias to the call, in this case, val is a variable, in the outer scope is 10, we get to see the 10. The 10 comes in, but it is that we don't remain connected to the val. So in a sense, you can see at the moment it comes to here, it actually makes a copy of its parameter, and then 10 is working here, and this becomes 20, and this becomes 20. So the return value is 20, and so dval ends up with 20 comes into dval, and then we print out 20, and so that's fine. But we notice here in this line that val is unchanged. That's the key to this. And the call by value, which is the normal way most variables are passed into functions, unless they're arrays or objects, but just a variable like 12 or a string, it's a copy. Copy as it's called, so that you can actually modify this on the left-hand side, and it's not modifying the original. That's to reduce the potential for side effects of a function. You just don't want the function to be able to do something to mess with the variables outside the function. And it's a good way to sort of draw a really solid boundary around the function and pass something in and get something back out and not have it mess with our variables. It's like just an isolation. And so call by value is pretty typical. What's cool about PHP is they also give an option to call by reference. And so when you say call by reference, and this is sort of a throwback to C, although C doesn't use, it uses the ampersand, but not in the exact same way, you basically put an ampersand in the parameter. And you are then, as the writer of the function, notifying the outside world that you are planning on changing this first parameter. And when you want to change the first parameter, you just put it over here on the left-hand side. And so, real thing is a 10, so val comes in as a 10, but it's not only 10, but it's also $val. So now $real thing is equivalent within the function to $val. It's not an alias to the value of $val, it is equivalent to. So what happens is of course, this becomes 10 because it is equivalent to $val, and then 10 times 3 is 30. 30, it goes into real thing. We have no return value, which is totally okay, but then we come back and we notice back here that val has tripled. And that's simply because we ran this assignment statement inside the function, and we said, we're going to mess with that. Give us the actual variable, not a copy of the actual variable. It's important because as you're reading the PHP documentation, you might find that the sort function takes an array as a parameter, and it is telling you right here that it is planning on changing it. And so that's a clue to you when you're reading documentation that parameter is going to be altered. And so you're going to sort this array, and it's going to rewrite that array in place. So you know that that's going to happen. Up next, we'll talk a little bit more about how the function is isolated from the rest of the code, how that function can break out of that, and other aspects of PHP modularity.